Hello friends, welcome to our channel ICSE Easy Learn. So today we are going to do settlement patterns on topo sheets. Okay, so I hope that you have done up to the part 2 and you understood all the points. So let's start. First of all, what do we mean by settlement? Settlement are simply the group of houses. Okay, and they are usually in villages or towns where people live. Okay, and the size depend on the availability of road, railway, hospital, police station, administrative building, rest houses and so on. Okay, so the size of a settlement, the size of the number of houses that are in a village or in a town depends upon these factors, that how many roads are there, how many railways, hospital, police station, administrative building, rest houses and so on. So settlement grow over a period of time. How can we say that? So you can, in this, you know, in this aspect, you can, you know, ask to your father or your grandfather about that 20 to 50 years ago. Okay, the city or the village in which you are living is very much small in size. But nowadays, as you can see and observe, the size of your village and city is increased. Okay, so the settlement grow over a period of time. Many factors determine the location and type of settlement. So there are many factors that decide that what is the location of the settlement and what is the type of settlement. Okay, so first point is, let me mark it. So the first point is that settlements grow in areas that are flat and where the land is cultivable. Okay, फर्स्ट पॉइंट क्या है कि जो सेटलमेंट है, मीन्स जहाँ पर लोग अपना घर बनाते हैं, वो लैंड क्या होता है, फ्लैट होता है. कभी भी आपने ये नहीं देखा होगा कि सी दिस इज अ माउंटेन और किसी ने यहाँ पे स्टीप स्लोप के ऊपर घर बना रखे हैं, ऐसा कभी नहीं होता. ओके, बिकॉज पीपल ऑल्सो ऑलवेज प्रेफर द फ्लैट और द प्लेन्स. ओके, सो एरियाज दैट आर फ्लैट एंड सेकेंड मोस्ट important thing is land is cultivable. Cultivable means the people can practice agriculture over that land. So first is that settlement grow in areas that are flat and where the land is cultivable. Settlement do not grow on steep hillsides or marshy land like deserts. Okay, so where the, you know, the land is not fertile, there can't be any settlement. Now second is that settlements grow in places where water is available in plenty. So where the amount of water is high, the settlement is also high. Okay, so for both, so they need, you know, water is needed for both the agricultural, because they are, you know, making the their settlement where the land is cultivable. If there is cultivable land, then they must practice agriculture, and if they are practicing agriculture, then they must need plenty of water. That's why the places where water is available in plenty for both agricultural and domestic purposes. Okay, settlements therefore always grow on the confluence of rivers. It means that on the banks of the rivers. Okay, so from the ancient history we can see that, like the Indus civilization, we can see so many civilizations are just scattered on the banks of rivers, because on the banks of the rivers the land is also fertile. Okay, the land is cultivable and they can practice agriculture, and for agriculture they need water. Water is also fulfilled by the rivers over there, and the land is also flat. That's why from the ancient time the civilization, the people made their settlements along the rivers. Okay, so now the third point is settlements are also thrive on a plateau because of the flat surface of the plateau. So as you can see, this is a plateau and this one is the flat surface where the settlements and the houses can be made. Okay, and also the land of this is you know, cultivated and agriculture can be practiced. So next is that they develop and grow in places where the climate is suitable or pleasant to live in. Okay, so the settlement or the people grow their houses or develop their houses in the places where the climate is suitable or, you know, pleasant to live in, you know, extremely hot, cold and wet or dry places are not attractive settlement sites. So no one makes his or her house in that area where the temperature is very much hot, very much cold, wet or dry places. Okay, settlements are formed where there are prospects for employment. Okay, where there are aspects or where there are chances of getting job or the employment rates are high, at that place settlements are formed. Okay, so mines and industries in the area are potential sources of employment, because in the mines and industries jobs are very much huge and encourages growth of settlements. Such places are usually near places of abundant raw materials for growth of industry. So such places are usually near places of abundant. So these places are near abundant. So for the growth of industry. So where industries are formed? Industries are formed where they get the raw material in an abundant form in a large quantity. Next is, they develop in places that are easily accessible by various kind of roads, rivers and railway lines. Easy access to and from the settlement will allow movement of people and goods from one place to another. So now these are some of the factors on which settlement depends upon. Now a settlement can be permanent or temporary. Settlements that are constructed and occupied for a short time are known as temporary settlement, and temporary settlement are built by people engaged in hunting and gathering, because in the work when they are doing hunting and gathering, they don't live at one place for so many days or so many days. What they are doing over there is they just make temporary homes out there, and when they have hunted the animal, after that they went to another place and make temporary settlement again. So shifting cultivation and transhumance. So tents and huts are the most common form of shelter in temporary settlement. At time a temporary settlement is built next to a construction site such as bridge or a flyover. However, this form of temporary settlement is usually found in an urban area. A temporary settlement can become permanent with time. Okay, next is permanent settlement. People build permanent houses. In course of time, several such structures are constructed and a settlement develops. So the availability of water and land for cultivation are important reason for the growth of such settlement. In addition, there is availability of communication lines such as roads and railways and other facilities such as police station, post office, hospital or a health center, market. So okay, temporary kya hota hai, jahan pe hum apna temporary ghar banate hain, hut ho gaye, tent ho gaye, par jo permanent सेटलमेंट होती है वो कंस्ट्रक्ट की जाती है ब्रिक्स के द्वारा. ओके, नेक्स्ट इज टाइप ऑफ सेटलमेंट. सो देयर आर टाइप्स ऑफ सेटलमेंट्स आल्सो. सो अ टोपोशीट हैज सेवरल सेटलमेंट पैटर्न्स. द थ्री मेन, दे हैव गिवन अस थ्री मेन टाइप ऑफ सेटलमेंट पैटर्न्स. फर्स्ट वन इज न्यूक्लिएटेड सेटलमेंट्स. सो व्हाट डू वी मीन बाय द न्यूक्लिएटेड सेटलमेंट? इन न्यूक्लिएटेड सेटलमेंट बिल्डिंग्स एंड हट्स आर इन कॉम्पैक्ट क्लस्टर. I hope this is the only word. Yeah. So in nucleated settlement, the buildings and the huts are in a compact cluster. These settlements are usually found in plains or valleys. This kind of settlement indicates that the community is living in an area where the land is fertile and good for agriculture. Nucleated settlements generally have a well-knit and large community. Apart from houses, essential facilities like hospitals, police station, post office, school and administrative buildings are found. So nucleated settlement, also known as cluster settlement, as you can see, let me show it to you. So this shows a nucleated settlement. As you can see, all clusters are formed, okay, on the four sides of a lane. So second type of settlement is linear settlements. So what is the definition? Linear settlements are those that are formed in a line. Okay, as you can see in this diagram, this is a road and these are formed along the sides. In a line they are formed. Houses, shops, dhabas, petrol pumps and garages develop along the side of roads, railway lines or river banks. Gradually these linear settlements grow in size. Okay, so these settlements gradually develop into trading center also. If they are near a railway track, over a period of time, then a need for a railway station is felt, then it become a रेलवे स्टॉप. ठीक है, मान लो कि यहाँ से कोई रेलवे ट्रैक जा रही है, ठीक है, और यहाँ आसपास शॉप्स हैं लीनियर के अंदर, तो क्या होगा, एक बार ऐसी ज़रूरत पड़ेगी कि यहाँ पे क्या हो जाएगा, फिर एक रेलवे स्टेशन हो जाएगा जहाँ से यात्री निकलेंगे और वो मतलब कि जो उनका ज़रूरत का सामान है वो यहाँ से ले सकेंगे, बिकॉज देर आर शॉप्स और अ ट्रेडिंग सेंटर. ओके, इन अ लाइन. So when located and if they are on the main roads, then such settlement become important stop for traveler as dhabas, tire and car repairing shops and petrol pump are set up. On rivers and coasts, they become places where boats can unload goods and passengers. Now the next one is scattered settlement. So scattered settlement are also known as dispersed settlements. Houses or huts in this type of settlement are far apart from one another. If one is here, then another is here. So on the map, such a settlement is indicated by long distance between houses. Areas of scattered settlement indicate sparse population. Okay, if the area is more than the we can say that the population is less, and this you can see in this diagram, a scattered settlement. Okay, the houses are very much far apart. We can see the distance now, and the absence of proper road. So there is no proper road. Houses or huts are usually connected by car tracks or path. In dispersed settlement, cattle rearing is common as each household has cattle that is allowed to graze in the open fields. Also the land is not very fertile to support a big population. And let's move forward. Now next is transport and communication. So on a topographical map, you will notice some black line that cross the map. These lines are symbols of roadways and railway tracks and indicate the type of communication in the area. They depict the various modes of transport being used in the area. So on a topo sheet, there are metalled and unmetalled roads. Metalled roads are also available and non-metalled roads are also there, and they are indicated in the topo sheet. Vehicles such as trucks, buses, cars, jeeps and other modern means of transport move over metal road. So the vehicles of great importance like truck, bus, car, jeep, or we can say other modern means of transport move over metal road. There are also cart tracks, pack tracks and footpath, which are unmetal roads. Car tracks and pack tracks connect small village settlements in rural areas, while footpaths are normally found through hilly terrain, which is inaccessible even by car. So pack track too are found in hilly and rough terrain, where goods are loaded on backs of mules and ponies and taken from one remote village to another. The layout of roads and railways are planned according to the relief and drainage of the area. The abundance of bridges indicate the many streams that exist in the area. Tunnels and cutting indicate hilly terrain. Tunnels या फिर कटिंग हो, वो क्या इंडिकेट करते हैं, हिली टेरेन को. रेल रूट आर प्लान थ्रू एरियाज दैट प्रोवाइड एज लिटिल ग्रेडियंट एज पॉसिबल सिंस ट्रेन्स हैव टू होल्ड हैवी गुड्स टू अवॉइड स्टीप ग्रेडियंट. टनल्स एंड कटिंग आर मेड फॉर रेलवे ट्रैक टू रन थ्रू. तो जहाँ पे स्टीप ग्रेडियंट होते हैं, तो स्टीप ग्रेडियंट को अवॉइड करने के लिए टनल्स और कटिंग्स बनाए जाते हैं, जिसके अंदर रेलवे ट्रैक्स बिछाए जाते हैं, ठीक है, जहाँ से हमारे रेलवेज पास करती हैं. एम्बैकमेंट होती हैं, मतलब कि रेलवे we can say embankment or raised construction built on the ग्राउंड ओके एम्बैकमेंट मीन्स कि जो उनकी बैंक्स होती हैं बाउंड्रीज होती हैं उनको हाई लेवल कर दिया जाता है दे आर ऑफन यूज टू प्रिवेंट फ्लड वाटर ठीक है मान लो कि ये एक पानी है इसके चारों तरफ बड़ी बड़ी दीवार खड़ी कर देना जिससे कि पानी बाहर ना जा सके या फिर अंदर ना आ सके और फ्लड की कोई सिचुएशन ना हो सके फ्रॉम एंटरिंग द लैंड रोड्स एंड रेलवे ट्रैक्स आर बिल्ट ऑन दिस एम्बैकमेंट्स सिंस द ग्राउंड बिलो इज टू सॉफ्ट टू सपोर्ट अ रोड और अ रेलवे ट्रैक कॉजवेज आर ऑल्सो बिल्ट ओवर स्मॉल स्ट्रीम्स और मेटल रोड्स इन इंडिया थ्री टाइप की होती हैं रेलवे गॉजेस ब्रॉड मीटर और नैरो जो ब्रॉड होती है ब्रॉड गोज लाइन्स होती हैं वो डबल ट्रैक और सिंगल ट्रैक से डबल ट्रैक मीन्स दो सेट हैं एक ये और एक ये ट्रैक का और सिंगल का मतलब सिर्फ एक सेट है ट्रैक्स का ओके और सेकंड हमारा कौन सा रेलवे गोज है सेकंड इज अवर मीटर ओके मीटर गोज कहाँ पे मिलता है हमें ईस्टर्न कॉर्नर ऑफ हमारी कंट्री के अंदर मिलता है थर्ड वन इज नैरो गोज ठीक है ये हमें हिल स्टेशन पे मिलता है दार्जिलिंग इन वेस्ट बंगाल शिमला इन हिमाचल प्रदेश कम्युनिकेशन एंड ट्रांसपोर्ट लाइन इंडिकेट द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ अ प्लेस ठीक है कौन इंडिकेट करती है कि एक प्लेस की इम्पोर्टेंस कितनी है कम्युनिकेशन और ट्रांसपोर्ट लाइन क्या इंडिकेट करती है कि एक प्लेस की इम्पोर्टेंस कितनी है व्हेन मेनी रोड्स एंड रेलवे लाइंस कन्वर्ज इन अ विलेज और अ टाउन इट इंडिकेट द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ अ प्लेस इट कुड बी फॉर सिवरल रीजन सच एज इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटी ऑफ द रीजन और द रीजन कुड बी अ टूरिस्ट हॉटस्पॉट और इट कुड बी बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रेजेंस ऑफ industries and factories leading to plenty of job opportunities airports okay so airports are also an important form of travel and communication but airport are confined to large cities only we can't see airports in a small city so the conventional sign of an airplane indicate the presence of an airport or an airstrip now let's study how to read and interpret a topographical map so let's see on page number 19 first okay so this is a topographical map and with this aspect we are going to see we can say that topographical map interpretation we are going to see okay so a topographical map a part of which you see on page number 19 which I have shown you now only provide a lot of information of both natural and man-made features okay natural feature are the physical feature like hills valleys ridges plain plateaus depression and so forth while man-made are like canal dam bridges railway line car track highways buildings and so on okay so we have done the conventional sign and symbol or and the colors different colors of these you know of these features in our previous classes okay so these are the aspect you should bear in mind as you study a topographical map so here we are going to see something like that so the first thing that you should keep in your mind while you know having or interpreting or reading a topographical map is the sheet number okay so sheet number is always on the top is always on the top of the map okay example is like 24D by 7 this number refer to a specific geographic area so this 24D by 7 this is related to a specific area specific location like a part of Banaskantha and Sirohi district of Gujarat and Rajasthan okay and these are on the top of the sheet and the second one is the scale okay scale is written always in at the bottom okay like you know the scale of the sheet is found at the bottom we have done the scales okay like 1:10,00,000 okay and also we can say that 1:50,000 what does it mean that 1 centimeter on the map indicate 50,000 centimeter on the ground or in the other words we can say that we can say that 2 centimeter on the map is equal to 1 kilometer on the ground. Okay, now third one is grid. So grid we have already done that eastings and northings are known as a grid. Okay, and see 2 centimeter, one grid. One we can say nothing is 2 centimeter, easting is also 2 centimeter. When we multiply, it came 1 kilometer into 1 kilometer, because 2 centimeter is equal to 1 kilometer. That's 1 square kilometer is the area. Now next is direction on the map sheet. Okay, so this one should be north, then this one north, on the right side east, and on the left side west. Next is eastings and nothings. So the map extracts show easting up to this range and nothing up to this. So you can see this on page number 19. Okay, and you embark on your map reading exercise. So easting and nothing we have already done. 4-figure and 6-figure grid, this we have also done. All they have given is 4-figure and the 6-figure grid square, which we have done earlier. Next is legend and keys. Legend contain convectional. So what are legend? Legend are the convectional sign and symbol in the form of key. Okay, now before you proceed, before we start interpret the map, okay, we should familiarize ourselves with the signs and symbols, okay, which help us to interpret the map more accurately and in for the required information about relief, drainage, land use, transport, settlement, etc. Okay, now next is our contour interval. Okay, contour interval, it what does it mean is that, see, in the vertical line, these are the two vertical contour lines. The distance between two contour lines is 20 meter. Okay, and this is known as contour interval. Also we can say that it is also known as VI, vertical interval. Okay, now it is constant. Okay, now spot height. Spot height, we can say that area above the sea level, or the height above the sea level, is known as the spot light on the topo sheet. Next one is triangulated station. What we are doing over here is we are making a triangle and writing the number. Okay, it also indicate we can say height. Okay, on the map, it the triangulated station indicate the height on map. Okay, as you can see example, first of all we are making a triangle and then writing the number, grid reference also afterwards. Contour index. Okay, so what is contour index? So see, first line is like this, second, third, fourth. Okay, but the fifth line, is like this. It is bolder. Okay, so this is known as the contour index. Next is on this map there are several places with letter DEP. In circle, so in the circle they are writing DEP. Okay, and it means depression. The letter stand for depression. It indicate land in this area is at a lower level than the surrounding area. What does the depression mean? What does this symbol mean? It indicate that the area is low, at a lower level than the surrounding area. Now next is the main water body that flows right across the map extract in the Banas River, the tributary that joins it in the Balaram Nadi. Okay, next is dry and wet streams. Okay, so dry and wet, so there are two colors of the streams. If the stream color is black, then it means that the stream is dry. Okay, but if it is blue, then it means that the stream is wet. Okay, only this. So there are several type of contour features. Okay, as we can see, saddle bhi ho sakta hai. Saddle is like this. Okay, and a pass is the space between the two hills. Then ridge could be also there, and a watershed. Okay, so next is a map has three dominant color. First one is green, yellow and white. ओके, ग्रीन क्या डिनोट करता है? ग्रीन डिनोट करता है वेजिटेशन या फॉरेस्ट. नाउ फॉरेस्ट आर ऑल्सो ऑफ थ्री कैटेगरीज. एक होता है डेंस जंगल, ठीक है, सेकेंड होता है डेंस मिक्स जंगल, और थर्ड होता है फेयरली डेंस जंगल. ठीक है, येलो कलर क्या डिनोट करता है? येलो कलर डिनोट करता है कि कल्टीवेटेड लैंड है. और वाइट क्या शो करता है? वाइट शो करता है बैरन लैंड. ओके, और मान लो कि बहुत ज़्यादा येलो लैंड है, ठीक है, और उसके अंदर कहीं स्पॉट है वाइट का, इसका मतलब क्या है कि वो जो जंगल है वो डिफॉरेस्टेशन उसके अंदर हो रही है, उसके अंदर लार्ज अमाउंट के अंदर जो ट्रीज है उनको कट किया जा रहा है. ओके, नाउ यू कैन नोटिस इट ऑन पेज नंबर 19. यू कैन सी अ स्पॉट एट अ हाइट ऑफ 522 इन ग्रिड स्क्वायर, दिस नंबर. ओके, नाउ मैन मेड ऑब्जेक्ट लाइक सेटलमेंट, रोड, कार ट्रैक, टेम्पल, ट्रीज एक्सेट्रा इन दिस मैप यू कैन सी. सेटलमेंट कम इन डिफरेंट पैटर्न. वी हैव डन न्यूक्लिएटेड, स्कैटर्ड एंड लीनियर. ऑन दिस मैप दे हैव शोन दैट यू नो एग्जाम्पल ऑफ न्यूक्लिएटेड ऑल्सो, स्कैटर्ड ऑल्सो, लीनियर ऑल्सो दे हैव गिवन. ओके, नाउ लास्ट इज अवर ट्रांसपोर्ट. सो ट्रांसपोर्ट, ऑल द सेटलमेंट ऑन द मैप आर कनेक्टेड बाई कार ट्रैक्स, द ब्रोकन रेड लाइन फ्रॉम जुवॉल टू चेखला एंड फ्रॉम चेखला टू खरा आर पैक ट्रैक्स. ठीक है, तो रेड लाइन जहाँ पे ब्रेक होती है उनमें उससे हमें क्या इंडिकेट होता है कि देर आर पैक ट्रैक्स. ओके, सो आई होप दिस चैप्टर इज अवर कंप्लीटेड एंड आई होप दैट इट इज you know quite clear to you. So if you love watching this video, then you can like the video and share it with all your friends. And this chapter is completed, so any doubt related to this chapter you can write in the comment section. Most welcome for your doubts. And also tell which chapter for geography class 8 you must want that I'll teach you in the next or the coming videos. So thank you and be connected. Bye bye, meet you in the next video.